where are you looking?
Holy fucking shit, the madman actually did it. That's right, this is the first ever official Digibro t-shirt made entirely by me. As in, printed, screened, made, I did everything. And I'm gonna ship it to you for the low, low cost of $30 domestic. And 35 if you live in Canada, and 40 if you live anywhere else, because that's how much the shipping escalates. It took me a while to figure out exactly how much it was going to cost to produce these shirts, to do all the shipping. I've run a whole experimental run that I did with my patrons over the last week or so, so this is a fully tested formula for success. The total cost of producing one of these shirts and shipping it, you know, aside from the international, is about $10. The additional cost is entirely the effort it takes for me to make it worth my while to actually go through with producing these shirts, and just having extra profit pocketed. So what is the shirt exactly? It only comes in white. It's a Hanes t-shirt, and the design is Digibro versus the Kiritos. As you can see, I am the boss. This is the art-so-fart-so character where he's got a cigar in the mouth and using a Nerf gun about to sweep across all these Kiritos with a big fucking attack. You've got your traditional Kirito in the just left of center on your screen. In the middle is blonde Kirito from Alicization. On the far left, we've got ReZero Kirito. On the far right, we have Kirito from the Asterisk War, and next to him is Kirito from... what the fuck is that show called? The one that was the We Have Accepted Mediocrity video. Oh, God. I don't even remember the name of the goddamn show. Well, there you go. As you can see, the name, Digibro, because I just wrote this one in and then I put on the shirt, it got sloppy. But I handwrite in my own name, so it's a signed shirt, signed with this poster goop. Or not poster, but t-shirt paint. This stuff does not come off. You know, I may made a few shirts using this before that we have continually washed, had no problems with it. Honestly, the graphic is more likely to get damaged in the wash than that is. I will be pre-washing these shirts. I have not pre-washed the ones that I currently have. In my test run, I was using Gildan shirts, and the ones that I made for me and May, we washed them. There was a little bit of loss of graphic, not a major loss, but it definitely damaged it a little bit. So I've heard that pre-washing can help to prevent that. So unless you are unlucky to receive the shirt I'm wearing in this very video, you'll know by the way it's signed. You know, you're gonna get a pre-washed shirt that hopefully won't have a damaged graphic. As you can see, the Kiritos are choosing between Burst, Link, and Run. The design of this shirt is in reference to the battles from Phantasy Star 4, an RPG that's for the Sega Genesis. That's why the black bars, that's why the exact text is the Phantasy Star font. So yeah, that's the whole design. Now, I only have 50 shirts that I'm going to sell. Well, technically 53. But I have 53 shirts. And that's all it's going to be. Once those are sold out, this design is going to be temporarily, at least, retired. It might come back one day if by popular demand, if, you know, there's too many people who wanted it and not enough people who got it. But, you know, I'm not here to become a full-time shirt salesman. I'm going to do this every once in a while, and probably with a different design each time. I might make old designs available in future runs of shirts. But, you know, basically it's going to be a certain number of shirts per run. So, the exact numbers I have, I bought 30 larges, of which I already used one for my Murica t-shirt. So, we'll say I have 29 larges, I have 15 extra larges, and I have 5 mediums. I also have 4 small Gildan shirts that are left over from my test runs. This is, you know, the numbers I bought were based on the amounts that I sold in my test run. Generally, most people wanted larger XL. I did not get any double XLs because it costs a lot more to buy a double XL blank shirt for some reason. So apologies to anybody who needed double XL. Personally, I am 180 pounds. This is a large shirt. It fits me just fine. You know, I'm starting to get a little big for it, but it fits snugly. It looks good on me. Again, these are Hanes shirts because I don't like the way the Gildan shirts feel. I think they're itchy. So, you know, if you've tried out both, generally when you buy shirts online, they tend to be Gildan shirts. So now that we've established what these shirts are, I'm sure a lot of you are probably wondering why. Why would I go to all the trouble of printing my own shirts, selling them to you directly, when I could just use Teespring, Redbubble, Spreadshirt, etc.? Well, personally, I'm not a big fan of buying shirts online, usually because they tend to be very low quality. You usually end up with Gildan shirts. There are some companies that you can work with that have higher quality shirts, but it tends to be a they contact you kind of thing. Or at the very least, I don't know how to get into contact with a better shirt seller. I don't have those kinds of connections or know how to get them. You know, I admire the way that Dick Masterson from The Dick Show, you know, worked with a seller that would make higher quality shirts for a lower price, and he sells them at a very low turnover. He only probably profits like $2 or $3 off the shirt, but he's selling to thousands of people. I don't expect any design I make to sell to a whole lot of people. And so if I'm operating on a low profit margin, then it basically isn't worth it for me. And I don't want to sell you low quality shirts from like Teespring for $5 a shirt when probably only 10 or 15 people are going to buy it that way. This is based on my experience, you know, doing various types of shirt sales. So back when I Am Games launched, before we even made the YouTube channel, Tom and I had made the t-shirt and we put out a tweet basically saying, like, hey, we have 10 of these blank shirts on hand. We will, you know, we'll make as many designs as we have shirts. Who wants one? And we sold out of them within about a day and a half. Then we put that same design up on Spreadshirt and Redbubble, and we started the YouTube channel. We promoted those shirts in every single video that we made, and we sold maybe two or three. Because people don't necessarily like the experience of buying on those sites. People who are foreign can't always get them to come to their country. They don't always have them in, you know, in better sizes. They don't always have them in, again, high quality. They're usually Gildan shirts, which, again, I'm not a big fan of. So, like, even though the shirts we were selling were no better in quality, they were also Gildan shirts, it was just the experience of buying it from us directly, knowing that we're pocketing all of the profit, that it's something that was handmade by us, that we could sign, we could ship to you directly. That seemed to be what people wanted, even more than just the shirt itself, more than just having a shirt with that graphic, was the experience of buying it from us. So that's what I'm offering you more than anything. This is, again, a signed shirt. I wrote my name on it myself. I did the design. I did the printing. I did everything. And, you know, for that reason, I only have white. I only have a few sizes. So it's not as though I have all the options available. I'm, you know, limited in my audience in that way. But again, selling through those websites does not excite people the way that buying it directly does. And I will get 100% of the profit from these shirts, which would be like $20, as opposed to the, again, $5 absolute maximum that I would make selling through one of those websites who are going to pocket the majority of what you pay them. So, you know, I sprung for the Hanes shirts at the very least, which is not a huge amount more. The Gildan shirts are like $1.75 each if you buy them in bulk. Hanes shirts are like $2.30 if you buy them in bulk. I just figured they'd be more comfortable and look better. It seems that way based on this one that I've printed compared to some of the Gildan ones I had before. So, you know, basically I'm building it to my taste. In the future, I might use even higher quality shirts depending on how big the profits from this end up being. It might cost more if I do that. It's always basically going to be adjusting price based on what I can do, but like at least I get to make all those determinations instead of the website making those determinations for itself, you know? It doesn't take me that long to produce these, so it's not like a huge endeavor. It's mostly just that, you know, this is a great way for me to give you a unique product you can't get anywhere else, that only comes straight from me, signed by me, and it will help me a whole lot, because if I manage to sell all 50 of these shirts, that'll be a pretty sizable chunk of change to help me through the rough summer months upcoming. such as going to Otakon, which I'm doing, where I'll probably take whatever t-shirts I have left and sell them to people who happen to be at the convention, probably at a discount since I don't have to ship them. So, you know, if you're going to Otakon, catch me there, get one of these shirts there. But anyway, yeah, that's the story. I'm now going to show you exactly how I made this shirt that's on my chest. And I'll also tell you how you can go about getting one of these. So, in order to get one of these, because of the fact that I only have so many of each size, and I'm not doing this through a storefront, basically I need you to send an email to vabeachhermitsociety@gmail.com. This will obviously be linked in the description, along with a full guide to how to do this. But all you have to do is send an email to that address letting me know what size shirt you want, and your address, and your which design you want. Because I'm also going to be selling the Murica design, because somebody requested it after seeing it on Twitter. People were like, I want to buy that shirt. So if you want to get that shirt, I will also print that one for you instead. You know. So yeah, go ahead and you send an email. Let me know your location so that I can tell you exactly what the cost is going to be, which size you want, which design. I will then confirm that I have that available. If I do, then I will send you a return email with a link to the PayPal address that you're just going to send me the money at. Again, the shipping and handling is already factored into the cost, so it'll be $30 domestic, $35 for Canada, $40 international. You just send me the money, and then once I've confirmed that I have it, I want you to put your email address in the note that you pay on PayPal. So, like, you know, when you go to pay, it'll say, like, do you want to send a message to the person you're sending this money to? Put your email address in there so I can confirm that it's the same person who sent that email. And once I have confirmed that, I'll go ahead and ship it to you. I'll make the shirt to order, print it, you know, ship it, whatever. Shipments will probably happen, I'll probably go out once a week to the post office. As far as I know, they come pretty fucking quick. You will get these shirts way faster than you would through Spreadshirt or something. The ones I shipped domestic today said they would get there by tomorrow. So, again, very fast travel. Yeah, so go ahead, send an email to that email address, or use the link down in the description, which will take you to a page that lets you see whatever designs are available. I will try to update the page with a number saying how many of each shirt I actually have so that you don't even have to send an inquiry if there's none left. It will just say there are no shirts. Anyways, now you can watch me actually create the shirt.
Hey!